Namaste, and welcome to your Get to Home with Thara Yoga series. I'm so excited for you that you've made this decision to take this step to creating the best you possible for 2016. So we're going to have so much fun. This is going to be a nice series for you to do at home in conjunction with your nutritional cleansing that you're also doing. So together, let's come to a seated position. So this is called Sukhasana. It's our happy seat. So if you're at home, you can take a towel, you can take a little blanket. I have two towels here. So we just place them in the middle, and then you sit your bum on top of the towels. And what that does is it just lifts your pelvis, your hips up a little bit above your pelvis. And then you cross your legs right in the middle of your shins, your calf muscles. And you can bring your hands, palms to your knees. You can actually turn them facing up so that they're open to receive energy, open to share energy. You want to just roll your shoulders down and back and go ahead and close your eyes and start to focus on your breath. So when we close our eyes, we're shifting our gaze inwards. You want to make sure that you keep your spine nice and straight so your trunk is lifted and your sit bones are melting down into the earth. And with your eyes closed, you're just going to focus on your breathing. So we're inhaling through the nose. Exhaling through the nose. Taking nice, slow, deep breaths. It's called Ujjayi breathing. Inhaling through your nose. Using the back of your throat as a passageway. Feeling that breath as it moves down into your chest, into your belly. Filling you up with life force, with prana, with energy for your day and for your practice. So just continue your nice, deep breathing. Inhaling. And exhaling. And let's start to visualize. Visualizing a little bit as we enter this new year, January 2016. What is it that you want to achieve in the year in front of you? So taking this time while you focus on your breath to visualize your future. What do you want? Who do you want to be? What are the things that you know that you need in your life to make you the best possible person? So you've already taken the first step in working on your health and your wellness, which is absolutely incredible. But just continue to see that vision of what it is that you want to achieve. You know, one of the things that is very important when we focus on things is that we don't focus on the things that we don't want. Don't worry about the things that you don't want. Don't think about those things. Let your focus solely be on the things that you want, whether it be, you know, a new boyfriend, or whether it be a new job or your career, whatever it is, whether it's your family life to be different, to be better, focusing your energy on that as you begin your practice today. And one of the things that I really love about yoga, which is different than going to the gym and putting your headphones on and running on a treadmill, is that you set an intention before you start your class. So yes, you're absolutely getting an awesome physical workout, but you're also connecting your mind, your body, your spirit all together as one, and you're setting that intention. So sometimes I'll say, maybe there's someone in my life that I know needs some love or needs some guidance or just needs some support, and I'll dedicate my practice to them. Or maybe sometimes it's as simple as dedicating your practice to yourself, sending yourself some kindness, some love, some patience, you know, whatever it is that you need in your life. So as you continue your breathing, starting to close your vision, locking it inside of your heart, and we're going to slowly start to open your eyes. Nice soft gaze, no wrinkles in your forehead, and go ahead and bring your hands, palms to your heart center, keeping your chest nice and lifted. Rolling your shoulders, blades together behind your back. You can gently shift your gaze down towards your heart center as you set your intention. Filling your heart with gratitude as you begin your practice. We will start our practice with one Om. Together we inhale. Om. From here, we're going to bring the hands palm down onto the floor so you can move your towels, your blankets out to the side, and you're going to come to our tabletop position. So, shoulders are in line underneath your wrists, your knees are in line underneath your hips, And we're just going to start with some gentle cat-cows. So we inhale, flip your toes, crown of your head extends forward. We exhale, rounding in like an angry cat, looking up at your belly button. Inhaling. Feeling your sit bones spread. Exhaling to round in. Letting everything go with your exhales. As you inhale, inhaling joy, inhaling positivity. As you exhale, letting go of all things in your life that don't serve you. Inhaling. And exhaling. And let's come back to a neutral spine. Stretch your hips back to your heels and reach your fingertips forward. So you're getting a beautiful stretch here. Your forehead can come down to the earth if it will reach. Sometimes for some of us, it may not. You're trying to keep your hips back with your heels. It might happen today. It may not. And then we're gonna come back to our tabletop all fours position. And from here, you're gonna lift your kneecaps. So kneecaps are lifted, belly is pulled in towards your spine. Your fingers are spread nice and wide. We're activating the core here. Now you're gonna start to lift your hips up towards the sky until you land in your downward dog. Now go ahead and walk it out a few times. You can bend your right leg, bend your left leg. You can wiggle your tail up towards the sky. Stretch your crown of your head down as you bend your knees a little bit. And then come back to stillness. And right now we're gonna hold your dog for 5 breaths. So, fingertips are spread nice and wide. There's energy shooting out of your heels. You're lifting your kneecaps and you're pressing the backside of your legs up towards the sky. Your crown is reaching down towards the floor. There's no tension in your cervical spine. Your gaze is at your belly button. You're breathing in through your nose and you're breathing out through your nose. Finding your stillness, even if it feels a little bit uncomfortable. Your shoulders are moving away from your ears. Your hips are up, you're hollowing out your core. Take one more breath here. And now we're gonna come forward into plank. Fingertips are spread nice and wide when we're in plank, and you're trying to achieve a straight line from your shoulders down to your heels. Things that you don't want to happen when you're in plank are your hips swaying down or your hips being up too high. So you wanna keep your core nice and active. Hips are just a little bit lifted. Your gaze is at the top of your mat. Your belly button is pulled in towards your center line. You're zipping yourself up, zipping up your midline. Energy shooting out of your heels. And now we're going to bend the knees. From here, bend your elbows, bring your chest, bring your chin down. Your pelvis stays up in the air. And now we slither through into a baby cobra. Tops of the feet press into the earth and you start to coil your spine up. From here, bring your hips back to your heels. Stretch it out. This is just part of a nice warm-up for you. Connecting with your body, starting to feel where maybe you feel some tightness, some tension. Lifting your toes, you press up, downward facing dog. Hips up towards the sky. We're gonna hold here and breathe for 5 breaths. Inhaling, exhaling. Hips up. Fingertips spread nice and wide, shoulders down your back. Inhaling. Exhaling. One more breath. From here, you're going to look forward. Pull your belly button in towards your spine and see if with straight legs you can walk your feet forward to meet your hands. If you need to bend your knees while you're walking up, that's perfectly fine. You do what's right for your body, for your practice. From here, like ragdolls, we're gonna roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. Head is going to come up very fast. And then you come to your mountain pose, Tadasana. So, mountain pose, Tadasana means your feet are rooted down, your kneecaps are lifted, your upper thigh bones are lifted, your tailbone is tucked, your core is active, your shoulders are down and back, your chest is open, hands, palms are facing away from you. Again, open to receive, open to share. So we're not holding on to things, we're not fidgeting with our clothes. but we're staying nice and open, nice and grounded, nice and rooted. Finding your stillness, finding your fierceness. We're gonna start with our sun salutations now. So you're gonna come to the top of your mat or towels with your toes and heels together. Inhaling your arms up, upward salute. This is Urdhva Hastasana. You're shifting your gaze and we're creating length in the spine. So we're reaching the arms up towards the sky. And then on the exhale, we're gonna fold down and let everything go. Release your head, release your neck, fold down. Take your hands to your shins, look forward, lengthen. This is Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, fold down, Uttanasana, forward fold. From here, stepping your right foot back, you're in a low lunge position. Fingertips are gently grazing the ground and you really wanna think of being extended. So you don't wanna be rounded, but instead lengthen. Fingertips are grazing, your shoulders are rolling down and back, your chest is open, you're offering your heart forward. Your right leg is strong, it's engaged. So, you don't want this right knee dipping down. You want to keep pressing the backside of the right leg up. Also paying attention to your left knee and your left ankle, you want to make sure that they're in one straight line. So if you find that you're leaning forward, that means that you need to shift the weight back, or sometimes it means that you need to take a wider step. Stepping your right leg back a little bit further. And the reason we want to make sure the knee and the ankle are aligned is because you don't want to put any pressure onto your left knee. So, right leg is nice and solid. And now we're going to step the left foot back to meet the right. Pulling your belly button in towards your spine. You're in plank pose now. Your gaze is at the top of your mat. Your fingertips are spread wide, energy shooting out of your heels. Your belly is pulled in towards your spine. You're strong and your breathing is easy. Holding here for a few breaths, breathing in, activating, waking up your core, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out. If any time you need to bring your knees down, that option is there for you. You can take a break and then come back in, breathing out. Now we're gonna do our first chaturanga push-up. So, you're going to bend your elbows 90 degrees. Your shoulders come a little bit forward, and then you flip into your upward facing dog. Shoulders relax down away from your ears. Your thighs are lifted. Your kneecaps are lifted. Flip your toes. You're back in downward dog. Hips are up towards the sky. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. Keep pulling your belly button in towards your spine, hollowing out your core, helping you to send your hips up a little bit higher. See your kneecaps lifting. Move your upper thigh bones up and back. One more breath. Beautiful. Inhale your right leg up. Trying to keep your hips square. Sweep your right foot through in between your hands. Trying to be light as feathers as that foot lands. Never really wanted to thud it down. Always remembering in yoga that everything we do, we're moving in a special way. From here, go ahead and step your left foot forward to meet the right, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, we rise up, upward salute. Exhale, we fold down, letting everything go. Hands to your shins, look forward, lengthen. Exhale, fold down, left foot steps back. Right knee, right ankle are in alignment. Always checking your alignment. Your left leg is solid. Pressing the back side of your leg up towards the sky. Your belly is pulled in. Your right side rib cage is just gently resting on the top of your right thigh. Your belly is pulled in. Your shoulders are open. Your chest is open. You're offering your heart forward. From here, go ahead and step your right leg back. You're in plank pose. 5 breaths here. It might get difficult. It may seem like you can't do it. Drop your knees down, take a break, and then come back in. Keep resetting, refocusing on that intention that you set at the beginning of the class. Always remembering that when we can achieve things in this space, things that maybe you didn't think you could achieve, it gives you the courage to do things off of your yoga mat. That is the ultimate purpose, right? Breathing in. Breathing out. Almost there, one more breath. Bending your elbows for chaturanga push-up. sweeping through into your upward facing dog or Dvamukha Svanasana, flipping your toes, pressing back into your downward facing dog, breathing in, breathing out. So really trying to work the kinks out of your legs. So as you can see your legs while you're in your downward dog, focusing on lifting the kneecaps and check your ankles, because that's like a very good indication for you. If you're trying to press your heels down, because you've seen people with their heels down and you want to do that too, yes, it looks very pretty. Except if you have wrinkles on your ankles, that's your cue that you need to lift your heels up a little bit. Our body gives us nice cues to tell us where we are at times. We just have to pay attention to them. Breathing in, breathing out. From here, go ahead and inhale your left leg up. Sweep your left foot through. Go lunge. Step your right foot forward to meet the left. Fold. Inhale to rise up. Up and salute. Exhale your arms down by your side. Come to your stillness. Breathing in. Breathing out. Toes and heels are together. We're going to start with half moon posture, Ardha Chandrasana. Inhaling your arms over your head, interlacing your 10 fingers. You're going to release your index fingers, cross your thumbs. You're trying to bring your arms back with your ears. You're trying to get your arms to lengthen. So we're going to bend the body right and left several times, right and left. It's a nice stretch. You can do this any time of day. It's a great warm-up for the lateral spine. It's also great for your kidneys. Cleansing, detoxifying. You're going to come back to center and focus on your setup. So your weight is in your heels, your tailbone is tucked, your kneecaps are lifted, your core is engaged, your upper body is leaning back, your arms are up with your ears, your palms are squeezed together. Take a nice inhale breath, reach up and over to the right side, pressing your hips out to the left. So we're trying to keep the right shoulder and the left shoulder in one line. Two shoulders in one line, two hips in one line. So common things that happen are the right shoulder goes back. So you want to try to rotate it forward. And then often we get the right shoulder forward and the left hip goes back. And you want to bring that left hip forward. Keep your shoulders and your hips in alignment. Feel that beautiful stretch down your left side body. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling to come down a little bit deeper. Go to your edge. Come down. Push, push, push. Change. Coming back up. We're going to do the other side. Take a nice inhale breath. Reach up and over to the left side of the room as you press your hips out to the right. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling to come down, trying to keep your two shoulders, your two hips in one line. It's a bit of a balancing act. Getting that left shoulder forward and the right hip forward. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling to go down a little bit deeper. Keep pressing the hips out to the right. Keep rooting your feet. Keep lifting your kneecaps. Keep squeezing your glutes. As you come down, push, push. Change, come back up. From here, we're going to do a backward bend. Open up your spine, a little backward flexion. You're going to press your hips forward towards the mirror. Lift your heart up. And now shift your gaze as you bring your arms back. Your arms are back with your ears. Change, coming back up. From here, pull your belly button in towards your spine. Extend forward. See if you can keep your legs straight. If you can't, then always bend your knees if you need to. That option is always there. And now we're going to do a little warm-up before we go into Padmasana, which is hands to feet pose. So bend your knees right, left. Squat down a few times. You can shake your head yes, shake your head no. Let everything go. And now you're going to bend your knees. And you really want to sandwich your stomach and your thighs together. They're really sandwiched together. You're going to grab your heels from underneath. Your little baby fingers are going to touch side by side. Roll forward, body weight to your toes as you lift your hips up towards the sky. Releasing your crown of your head down towards your toes. Your elbows are back behind your calf muscles. You're trying to get your legs straight, yes, but it's not imperative. What is imperative is that your stomach and your thighs stay sandwiched together, like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. You're rolling forward, your body weight to your toes, your hips are going up towards the sky, your elbows are back behind your shins, you're using your arm strength to help you to lengthen your spine down towards the floor, using your arm strength to pull, lengthen your spine down, pull, pull, change,
From here, releasing your hands out from underneath your feet, we're gonna go out of the posture the same way that we came in. So you interlace your 10 fingers, release your index fingers, thumbs across your arms with your ears, and you rise back up. And then arms float down by your side. Come to stillness, breathing in and breathing out. Toes and heels are together at the top of your mat. We're gonna inhale the arms up. Upward salute, exhale, we fold down. Hands to the shins, look forward, lengthen. Exhale, folding down. From here, we're gonna rise up into chair pose. You're gonna sit your bum back behind you as you reach your arms up. Go ahead and rotate your pinkies inward a little bit. Pull your belly button in so you can see your ribcage visible and sit down a little bit deeper. Please, in your heels, feel your sit bones spreading. As you sit down, keep your chest nice and lifted. Bring your hands, palms to your heart center. Go ahead and fold forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, folding down. Here we go again. You're gonna sit your bum back as you lift your heart. Getting a nice workout for your thighs, legs, but also giving your heart a little massage while we are in chair pose. When we sit down nice and deep, it moves our diaphragm up and actually gives your heart a massage. So you're not just toning your thighs, you're toning your heart. Sit down a little bit deeper, keep lifting your chest, shining your heart. Beautiful, bring the hands, palms down to heart center, fold forward. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling, folding down, right foot steps back, left foot steps back, you're in plank position. From here, we're gonna do a chaturanga push-up, bend the elbows, sweep through, upward facing dog, flip your toes, downward facing dog, breathing in, breathing out. Hips up towards the sky, your crown moving closer down towards the earth. Breathing in. Breathing out. We're gonna inhale the right leg up towards the sky. Sweep the right foot in between your hands. Low lunge. From here, we're gonna rise up into a high lunge. Now there's energy shooting out of your left heel. Try to keep the bend in your right leg. Your arms are reaching up, creating length in your spine, thinning your waistline, reaching up. As you exhale, see if you can melt down a little bit deeper. And now from here, we're gonna open up into warrior two. Now, your left heel comes down towards the floor. Your left back toe is pointing at about 11 o'clock on the clock. Your chin is over your right shoulder and your right leg is bent. Your right knee is tracking your big toe. You're reaching your arms apart in two opposite directions. Your shoulders are plugged into your armpits, so your armpits are hollowed out. You're reaching your two arms apart. Your left hand is waving goodbye to your past, and your right hand is reaching towards your future and all the opportunities that are there for you. From here, let's go ahead and take a peaceful warrior. I'm gonna reach those right hand fingertips up and back, keeping the bend in your right leg if you can. Getting a little backward bending, a little heart opening action here. Breathing in. Breathing out. Coming back to your warrior two. Chin is over your right shoulder. From here, we're gonna lengthen the right leg and you're gonna parallel your feet as you reach your arms apart in two opposite directions. Pull your belly button in towards your spine. Extend forward. Lengthen forward and now you're gonna walk your hands down the back sides of your legs so that you can get a nice tight grip underneath your heels, on the outsides of your feet, or on your ankles. Our goal, first and foremost, is for the legs to stretch. So the kneecaps have to be straight in order for the legs to stretch. Chin is away from your chest, inhaling, exhaling, using your arm strength to pull. You can widen your stance a little bit to get a deeper stretch. Chin is away from your chest, you're reaching your forehead down towards the floor. You're using your arm strength here again, so you're pulling your elbows back towards your shins, helping you to pull, lengthening your spine down towards the floor. Pull, using your breath, inhaling, exhaling, pull, pull, change. Arms out to the side like airplane wings, carefully rising back up. From here, you're going to turn your right toes back to the front, cartwheel your arms down, step your right leg back, you're back in your plank position. From here, bend your elbows 90 degrees, sweeping through.
Upward facing dog, flipping your toes.
Downward facing dog. Hips are up towards the sky, your fingertips are spread nice and wide. Kneecaps are lifted. Lengthen your spine, lengthen your arms, lengthen your hamstrings. Inhaling your left leg up. Sweep your left foot through in between your hands. Low lunge. From here, we're gonna rise up. High lunge. Reaching your arms up. Creating length. Keep engaging that right leg, squeezing your right glute. As you reach up, keep the bend in your left leg. Breathing in. Breathing out. One more inhale. And then we're gonna open up into warrior two. On your next exhale, reaching your arms apart. You're squeezing your shoulder blades together behind your back, so you're giving your heart a little hug from the back side. Reaching your arms apart as you breathe. Keep the bend in your left knee. Keep your left knee tracking over your left big toe. Keep your right foot nice and grounded, nice and rooted down. Sometimes you have to remind yourself to re-engage your kneecap. You have to remind yourself to press the outside edge of your foot down. Becoming aware of all the little tweaks that you can make in your body. Let's take a peaceful warrior. Reaching the right hand down your back leg. And reaching your left hand fingertips up and back. Getting a little backward bend. And then from here, we're gonna pivot the left toes back in. Parallel your feet, reaching your arms apart. We'll do a second set of separate leg stretching. You can do it a little bit differently this time if you like. You can interlace your 10 fingers behind your back and extend forward. Bring your arms up over your head. For a little bit of a deeper shoulder opener as well this time. So chin is away from your chest. As you lengthen, pull your belly button in towards your spine. Hollow out your core, lift your hips up, root your feet down. Arms up, pull. We're going to carefully rise back up, arms back out to the sides, pivot your left toes back to face the front, you're back in warrior two, go ahead and cartwheel your arms down, left foot steps back, you're in plank, go through your flow, into your upward facing dog, into your downward facing dog, holding here and breathing, breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, breathing out. From here, we're gonna come forward into plank pose, and now you're gonna bend your elbows and come down so that you're set up for cobra pose. So your hands, palms are gonna be underneath your shoulders, your five fingers are together, your toes and heels are together. You're pressing the tops of your feet into the earth. Your chin is on the floor. Take a nice inhale breath. And start to lift your chest up. Rising your chest up, using your low back strength. Your shoulders are not up, they're down, away from your ears. You're reaching your elbows towards the back of the room. Lift your chest, lift your heart. And carefully come down. You're gonna rest your left ear on your mat or your towel. Your arms down by your sides, belly down. Shavasana, your toes touch, your heels fall out. Breathing in, breathing out. From here, you're gonna bring your chin to the floor, interlace your 10 fingers behind your back, and start to lift your chest. And then you're gonna start to lift your legs. Lift your chest, lift your legs. We're using your middle spine strength here. Think of reaching your crown forward, reaching your legs away. Use your middle spine strength. Chest rises, legs rise. Using your middle spine strength, go ahead and carefully release down. This time you can switch. So you put your right ear on the towel and you look to the left. Your arms down by your side, your toes touch. Your heels fall out. Breathing in, back rises. Breathing out, back falls. And now we're gonna come. Bring your chin onto your mat, bend your knees.
floor bow. We're gonna bend the knees, grab the feet from the outside. Your knees are together to start. Chin is on the floor. Roll your shoulders back, open your chest. Take a nice inhale breath and start to kick. Kick your legs back, kick your legs up, point your toes. Roll your shoulders back, lift your heart, kick harder. Kicking your legs into your hands, kick back, kick up. One day you're gonna see your feet coming over the center line of your head. Kick, getting a backward bend against gravity, kick back, kick up, kick, kick. And then carefully releasing down. Letting your legs come down, left ear on the towel, looking to the right. Coming back to center, now you're going to use your arm strength. Press yourselves up. Go ahead and press back up into your downward facing dog. Lengthen your spine, lengthen your hamstrings, get a nice little reset going. Now you're gonna bend your knees, come down to the middle of your mats and towels for half tortoise, Ardha Paramasana. So your toes and heels, your knees, it's kneel down position, so your knees are together. The tops of your feet are pressing into the earth. Inhale your arms up, crossing your thumbs in prayer position. Chin is away from your chest, your core is engaged, and now you're gonna start to extend forward. Trying to keep your hips back with your heels, and your ultimate goal is to one day get your forehead to touch, then your little baby fingers to touch. Reaching forward with your fingertips, stretching back with your hips. Only your little baby fingers are on the floor, your arms, your elbows are lifted. You're massaging your pineal gland on the earth below you. You're breathing into your backside body. Your diaphragm is compressed onto the top of your thighs, forcing you to breathe into your lungs. The backside of your lungs, take a nice deep inhale and a nice deep exhale, sending fresh blood, fresh oxygen to your brain cells. Keep reaching forward, stretch your hips back. Squeeze your knees together, your arms are with your ears, and now you're going to carefully rise back up. Your arms float down by your side. Come to stillness. Okay, from here, you're going to sweep your legs out from underneath you. You're going to extend your right leg out corner-wise and bend your left leg. So you're going to bend your left leg and your left foot is going to massage the inner part of your right thigh. Inhale your arms over your head, switch to the right, and now you're going to round down all 10 fingers into your legs underneath your foot. Now, for some of us, we might not be able to do that. If you can't do that, you have the option of bending your knee as much as you need to get the grip underneath your foot. Over time, you will be able to extend the leg out. Over time, and then you're going to touch your forehead and your knee. So, the name of the posture is forehead to knee. So you want the forehead and your knee to touch. If you cannot get your forehead and knee to touch, then your knee touch your forehead too. That's the posture. You're rolling your left shoulder down, your left elbow down. One day, you're going to get both elbows to come down next to your calf muscles. Keep flexing your toes back towards your face. Push your knee down with the help of your forehead. And change. Carefully rising up. We're gonna take the left hand, drop it to the outside of your left hip. Lift your hips up. Press your hips up towards the sky as you reach your right hand fingertips up and back for a stargazer. Getting a little backward bend, a little heart opening. A little reach, reaching for the stars, reaching for whatever it is that you want in your life. Go for it. Reach for it. From here, we carefully come back down and take your right foot up and over your left knee corner. This is spine twist, Ardha Matsyendrasana. So you want to make sure you really ground your right big toe. You want to make sure that both hip bones are on the floor comfortably. So sometimes we sit on our heel. That's not what we want to do. Move your heel out of the way. Make sure that both bum cheeks are on the floor comfortably. You're going to press against the floor with your right hand to get your spine nice and straight. Inhale your left arm up. Push your knee back. Grab your left knee with your left hand. and start to twist.
Keep lengthening
and twisting. Chin is going over your right shoulder. You're pulling your low belly in, so we're really getting the nice cleansing and detoxifying benefits of this posture. We're wringing out your spine like it's a wet rag, a wet, dirty rag. You're wringing out all the toxins as you twist. Inhaling to lengthen, exhaling. Right shoulder, right side chest is opening up. Twist, twist, and release. You can take a counter twist if you need it. And then you're going to sweep your legs back behind you and your back and your downward facing dog. Hips up towards the sky. Breathing in. Breathing out. Then your knees come down. Sit your bum back down. And now let's do the other side. So we're going to extend the left leg out. Bend the right leg. Bring that right foot to the inside of your left thigh. Give your thigh a little bit of a massage. Inhale your arms up. Twist to the left, round down. Pick up your foot. And touch your forehead on your knee. Remembering that you can bend your knee as much as you need to get that contact between your forehead and your knee. Keep your belly pulled in nice and tight. We're giving your abdominal organs a nice internal massage here, giving them a nice warm bath, I like to say. Push your knee down. Also being aware of your right knee, your right hip. Trying to keep that down as well. And again, that might not happen, but at least you try, right? Flex the toes back, pull the belly button in, elbows down next to the calf muscle, and change. From here, inhaling the arms over the head, dropping the right hand down, reaching the left hand fingertips up and back for a nice stargazer. Open your heart, open your chest, press your hips up. Carefully coming down. From here, taking your left foot up and over your right knee corner, and again, becoming very aware. So make sure that you're not sitting on your right heel, and make sure that you're grounding your big left toe, rooting that foot down into the earth. Press your hands against your left hand against the floor to get your spine nice and straight. Inhale your right arm up, pushing your knee back, grabbing your right knee with your right hand, and then you twist. Pulling your low belly in, helping you to twist deeper. Rotating your left hip back down towards the floor. Sometimes the hip has a tendency to lift. Drop it back down, open the chest. Pulling the belly in, I always say this posture is at its most beautiful when your spine, when your belly is all twisted and looks like a wet rag. It's not always the most photo-friendly posture, but that's how you know you're doing it right. Pull your belly in as you twist. Chin goes over your left shoulder. Push your elbow back against the knee as you twist. Twist, twist, change. Carefully taking a counter twist if you like. And then from here, we're gonna extend both legs out in front of us. Inhale your arms up. Exhale, folding forward. You're gonna grab your big toes with what we call our yogi toe grip, so your second and your third fingers. Your thumbs are reaching back towards your face. Inhaling. Exhaling to pull. Extending from the lower spine down towards the floor. Now, for some people, getting the legs straight in this posture might not be possible. Bend your knees as much as you need to. And focus on keeping your spine nice and straight. That's the goal, first and foremost. So I don't want your legs straight, but then you're collapsing down like that. That's not the posture. I'd rather you have your legs bent and your chest open and you're leading with your heart. Inhaling, exhaling to pull. Flex your toes back towards your face one day. Elbows will come down next to your calf muscles. Keep flexing the toes back. One day you're going to be able to get your stomach and your thighs to sandwich together. Reach your forehead down towards your toes. Pull, pull, pull. And change, release. From here, go ahead and turn around. Lie down on your back. Heels touch, toes fall out. Hands, palms face up to the ceiling. Lie down on your back and relax and enjoy a nice, quiet Shavasana. Focusing on your belly, rising and falling. roll over onto your side. We're gonna come back to that same posture that we started this squeeze with. So we're gonna meet back in Sukhasana in your happy seat. You don't have to have the glyca underneath your bum now. You can just bring your hands, palms down towards your knees, relax your shoulders down and back, your spine should be straight. Feel your sit bones on the earth underneath you. Feel your chest being lifted. Hopefully feel nice and calm, nice and relaxed after your workout. And go ahead and bring your hands, palms to your heart center. Shift your gaze down towards your heart center. Thanking yourself for your practice today. From here, we're going to take three cleansing breaths. Inhale the arms up. On the exhale, bring your hands, palms down to the heart center. Lion's breath. Inhaling. Exhaling. One more. Inhale. Tuck your chin towards your chest, gently bow to yourself, thank yourself for your practice. Take the practice with you as you leave your mat. Have a beautiful, beautiful day. Don't let anyone steal your peace. Namaste.